Yeah, I'm Matt, and we're gonna start off to like try to get all of our files together before we start putting our show together. We're gonna try to get everything together in one spot. So first of all, if you see on my screen, Audacity. So if you don't already have it, this is where you get Audacity. It's audacityteam.org. And I'm going to recommend that you get the latest version of it and you only get it from the official website. So that way, when I'm going through things, you can follow along and you know what's going on and you're not going to be, there's not going to be a different layout or whatever. So first of all, you need that. Second of all, you need some songs. So I can't advocate to illegally source your songs, but I can advocate to legally support your artists that you play on your shows. So on my screen, you'll see I have Bandcamp. As we all know, they give a large percentage of their money to the artists, and it's a great way to find mostly anything you can find. If any of y'all are into like dance music, there's Beatport, which has tons of electronic and stuff. But if you have no other option and you have to use YouTube, which I don't recommend because of the quality, but you kind of have to, I recommend the program 4K Download, which is, they have a website if you want to write it down, 4kdownload.com. And that is 4, the letter K, and then the word download, all one word, .com. And that way you avoid the sketchy YouTube to MP3 sites that people try to recommend, but they can be full of nonsense and stuff. So definitely have all your songs together in one folder in one place before you try to put your show together, just so you can stay organized and keep up with all your files. Next, you're going to need an actual voice source. So right now you can hear me talking through an SM58. With an interface, which is, for those of you who don't know, an interface is kind of a little box. I don't have a long enough cord, but it's a little box that transfers this standard mic into a computer signal that like a computer can understand. But I mean, anything works. So I know a lot of you have no microphone, so you can use Zoom to record yourself. You can also use like Tascam, like field recorders, if you want to look that up. I know one person in the chat has access to that. And if you look up field recorders, they're extremely like affordable and they're maybe about this big and you can carry it around anywhere. They're battery powered and they you can take them anywhere and do your interviews remotely. And also your phone. If you absolutely have to, you can record interviews or record yourself with your phone. Say if you have a laptop without a mic, and what the extra step you would have to do is record yourself on the phone, plug it in via USB to your computer, and then just drag said voice file over. So I think that covers what we need. And I'll put that up on the screen for later use. So like I said, you have your songs, how you get anywhere, your DAW, digital audio workstation, which is Audacity today, or you can also use GarageBand or whatever you're comfortable with. You need your recording of the voice. I'll need that. Physically, you need a voice source, so a mic with an interface like I have, a USB mic, a field recorder, and then obviously a computer. So the first thing I'm going to bring up before I get into Audacity is Zoom. So with Zoom, you can actually, there's a little setting that you can record strictly audio. And if you're recording multiple people, you can record everybody in a separate file to keep things simple. And I'm going to show you how to get to said setting. Because I can't show Zoom, if you go, so your main screen should look something like this, the frame on the right. And at the top here, where my cursor is, you'll see a little gear. You'll click that. And then you'll come over and you'll see the screen on my left. And then you see general, video, audio, a whole bunch of stuff. But you want to click recording. And then there'll be a checkbox for saying, record a separate audio file for each participant. And you want to check that box because say, I know one person here, they do a lot of their interviews on Zoom. And if you're recording three or four people, you're going to want to have those people separately because, as we know, people talk differently at different levels, at different volumes. So you're going to want to be able to edit that. And it's going to be way faster than trying to manually cut and paste everything. Am I going too fast? Can I get a thumbs up if everything's good for everyone? Perfect. So you've got your songs and you've got your Audacity installed. And I'm going to go ahead and open up Audacity right here. And it should look something like this. I'm sure a bunch of you have used it. And I'm sure a bunch of you haven't used it. But we're going to start from the bare bones, no matter what. So the first thing, before you do anything, and this is to help the station and to help Dylan, to help people upload songs and your songs to get played on the radio, you're going to go to your preferences. That can be accessed by either, if you're on Mac, clicking the Audacity name at the top of the toolbar and clicking preferences. Or if you're on PC, you click edit at the top of the toolbar and you'll see a preferences setting there. So if you're on PC, it's edit preferences. If you're on Mac, you click Audacity and then preferences. Once you open that up, you'll see a whole bunch of text. You're going to go up to where it says quality. And you're going to want to make sure that the default sample rate says 44,100 hertz. And I'm not going to get into the science behind it because it's not important. What is important is that this makes it so things will sound properly and it'll work and it won't sound all crappy and distorted. On top of that, the default sample format, which starts at 32-bit generally, you need to bring it down to 16-bit for the same reason of everything sounding clear and nice, and it's not going to have any compatibility issues. So that's the first thing you need to do when you start up Audacity, before you do any recording, before you do anything. So once that's set up, you just click OK. It saves the settings. You're ready to start. So I know a lot of you have intro music. You have a theme song or whatever. You usually start with music. And if you don't, that's okay. We're just going to show you how to bring in a file. So let's say you have a theme song and you want to bring it in. What you want to do is take the file, bring it up here. So on the screen, you should see I have my Finder opened in Windows as Explorer. And I have all the files I need. I have my theme song. I have my normal songs, and I have my fake Zoom call or my Zoom call audio that I've got already from my pretend Zoom call, if you will. So since we're starting with the theme music, we're just going to drag in the theme music. And generally, it will load depending on how long it is. But the first thing you'll see is this screen. The audio waveform will appear. And depending on what it is, you'll want to cut off the tails and stuff, but we'll get into that later. So right now you have your theme song, and I'm not going to play it because it's just, I don't need to play it right now, but you can imagine that it's a short theme song. It's 20 seconds. Great. So now after your theme song, you want to start recording yourself, because after your theme, when it fades out, you talk generally. So to do that, it's simply a matter of going to the top of your toolbar, pressing tracks, add new, and then going to mono track, because usually mic source is in mono. And if you already pre-recorded your intro, you can always just drag it in just like the file. Anyways, so you'll see here, when you look at an audio track, you'll see the name, which is by default called audio track. You'll see a plus and minus with a sliding scale, and that's the gain, which is your volume, which can be slid all the way up and all the way down. Below that, you have your pan, so your left to right, which we don't really need. And then this empty box is where your waveform would appear, similar to the song. So to start recording in a certain place, you're going to want to go up to the top of your toolbar, and you'll see your pause, play, stop, back and forward, and record. But to the right of that, you'll see kind of like a capital I, or I don't know the actual name for it. But anyways, you'll see like this eye looking logo here that I'm hovering my cursor around. It's called the selection tool. And you're going to want to use that, and you're going to want to find a spot where you want to start talking. So I'm going to start right after the theme stops. I'm just going to click once. And so now when I record, it will start only from that point. And so now, obviously, you want to start recording your voice. And to do that, you need to first check, is your mic actually working? And you need to get a good level. And Audacity has a neat feature for that, which is monitoring. So beside all the tools at the top, those six icons with my cursor there, there's a little microphone icon. And beside that icon, there's a meter with as negative 54, negative 48, negative 42, and so on. And all that is your decibel level. And so when you're like talking, generally, I'll turn it on right now. So what you do is just click on the meter and it'll just start monitoring and you'll see it jump up and down as I talk. So you can see that when I'm far away and it's not good, it's going to be hovering around negative 30. But when I have it nice and it's clear and it's crisp, like how you hear me now in Zoom, it's going to be hovering between negative 18 and negative 12, which is kind of what you want in terms of voice. So if you want to, it's always a good guideline, between negative 18 and negative 12 for voice. It's just going to be clean, crisp. And no matter what device you're using, even if you drag in an audio file, when you listen to it in Audacity, if it's peaking around there, around between negative 18, negative 12, you're good to go. And to add to that, it seems obvious, but it might not be for some people because microphones are somewhat of a mystery machine. So I'm speaking clearly into the mic. I'm not getting too close, but I'm not going too far away. I'm just sitting comfortably, maybe four fingers widths away. And so it's going to get me my nice level. And it's going to sound super clear for broadcast and for whatever you need it to do. So now that we're good on monitoring, we can click that meter again because we don't really need to see it. Or you can keep it. It's up to you. And we're going to head over to the left where we see a big red circle, which is our record feature. So pressing that is going to start recording. So I'll record an example intro just for the sake of exercise now by using that button. This is CKCU 93.1 FM. You're tuned into an example workshop. And to stop the recording, you press stop on the left or space bar alternatively. That normally shouldn't happen, but I think I should be okay. Yeah, I'm okay. Ignore that little pop-up screens. Don't worry about that. That probably won't happen. And it hasn't happened to me in forever. Anyways, so I'm going to let you listen back to that through this, and you're going to see what I'm going to do with it after to make it sound a bit more clean and professional. This is CKCU 93.1 FM. You're tuned into an example workshop. And to stop the recording, you press stop on the left or space bar alternatively. So did that come through for everyone? Did you hear the audio? Okay, perfect. So as you can hear, I kind of described what was happening, and I don't really want that in my show, ideally, talking about what I'm going to do with a file, and nobody else wants to hear that. So staying on the said selection tool at the top left here, I'm going to select that region of nonsense audio, just select all of it, and then press the backspace key or delete key, and that's just going to get rid of that. Super simple. On top of that, usually with mics, there's always a little bit of noise. And when you abruptly just cut off an audio file like that, it's going to sound like a little pop. So the next thing we're going to learn about here real quick is the fade in and fade out. So to do a fade in, fade out, you're going to want to select the length of your fade out, staying on the selection tool. So for me, I know that at the end of my speech, there's nothing else. I'm not going to lose anything if I fade out within this region highlighted here. So I'm happy with that region. I'm going to go up to the top here. I'm going to press effect, and there'll be a whole list of effects, but the one you're looking for is fade out, right below echo, right above filter curve. You're going to click fade out, and while you can't see much with that, that's going to allow it to just fade out slowly instead of being an abrupt pop, which is kind of what you want, and it sounds more professional. Another way we can use the fade out is at the end of my theme song. So you can see here that my theme song has a bunch of audio, then it abruptly stops. So we want to do the same thing too, because we want to make it sound more professional. So we're going to select, again, using our selection tool at the top left. We're going to select the area we want to fade. We're going to go back up to effect at the top of the toolbar, scroll down to fade out, and just click it, and it'll do all the work for us. And you can see here that the audio waveform has changed. You see it was thicker here before, and it slowly becomes a small little guy, for lack of a better thing to call it. Anyways, so yeah, we have our intro, and then we have our speech. Is everyone following along still? Am I going too fast? We're good? Okay. And also, I just want to reiterate that if you have any questions as I go along, definitely open up your notepad or open up anything, a physical piece of paper, and write down a question so that you can remember it for the end of the workshop. So right now we have our intro and we have the, well, we have our theme music, sorry, which is this big waveform here at the top. And then we have our intro talking, which is just me saying the name of the program. So after that, we're going to want to go into a song, ideally, or that's how most people do it. Maybe you go into the interview, but we'll get into that later. Excuse me. So same thing as doing the theme song to import any song. You're going to go to your folders. So for me, I have my CKCU example show folder, and I'm going to pick my song that I want to put in right after, and I'm just going to drag it in. And it's like I said before, it's going to import, and then there you go. It just slams itself wherever it wants right at the beginning. And you don't want that. You see how like my theme song and this song, they're overlapping, and you obviously don't want two songs playing at the exact same time. So that brings us to the move tool. And the move tool is nice because it allows us to move things around. But to do that, we're going to have to select the audio first. So while we stay on our selection tool, we're going to double click the file, and as you can see, it's a bit brighter. It's a different shade of gray, if you will. It's almost white. So once we have that selected, we're gonna go up to our six tools here, and we're gonna click the time shift tool, and that's indicated by two arrows pointing either direction, left, right, horizontally. And once we click that, we can then click on our audio file, and just drag it as far away or as close as we want. So depending on how long you speak for here, you can just adjust accordingly. So that's great. But it's kind of hard from this view to kind of get the timing right. Like, you'll have to fidget kind of back and forth. So I'm gonna introduce the zoom command. So beside the shift tool, there's a magnifying glass. And if you can guess, it magnifies things. So that opens up this big magnifying glass with a plus in the middle. And when you click on the screen, no matter where you click, it zooms in. So that way we can see with more detail how to like affect the timings of things. Alternatively, we hold shift while having the magnifying tool, and you can see that my magnifying glass goes from a plus to a minus. So right now it's plus, I'm not holding shift. And this is minus while I'm holding shift. So in case I zoom in way too much or I don't need that much zoom, I can hold shift and then click anywhere on the screen to get a better idea of like how I want to work with my file. So we're at a good place now in terms of how zoomed in I kind of want my Audacity. So we're going to go back to the move tool, which is up at the top here, or alternatively called the time shift tool. So I'm going to adjust this. So it's just a bit, there's maybe a brief second pause right after I finish talking. So kind of, it flows better. It doesn't feel as uncomfortable. And again, we're going to try to fade that in. So to fade that in, like we've done before, we're going to go back up to our tools. We're going to click the big capital I or the time, the selection tool. And then we're going to select maybe 3 seconds of the song. And then to fade in again, top of the toolbar, we have all of our different tools, and go to effect, scroll down, fade in, since I'm starting at the beginning of a song. And once I do that, it creates for me, as you can see, a nice long fade in. And if I want to make it longer, I'll undo that with Command Z or Control Z. We can make it longer. So I can select all the way up to here and do the exact same thing. Effect, fade in. And so that way, I'll play it back to you in a second, but that way, it could, if you need a gradual fade in, you get a gradual fade in. It's all up to you, and it's your show with your timing and your pacing. So I'm going to go ahead and play that for you guys so you have a better idea of what everything sounds like from the beginning.
With this apple appliance, you can capture live video. Still motion pictures shot at high frequency. Blurring the line.
This is CKCU 93.1 FM. You're tuned into an example workshop. So I don't know if you guys heard that, right? It worked? Perfect. So as you heard, as it's not the best thing in the world for the sake of the workshop, but for the exercise, you can see I had my music. It fades in by itself, so I don't worry about that. But I faded it out, talked for a bit, introduced the show, and then I faded in my first song. So right now we're at a good place. And so after that, we're going to want to fade out of the song. So either using the bottom here where my cursor is, you'll see a bunch of time and stuff in your project rate. You're going to grab this bar, or with your left trackpad, just scroll over with your two fingers. You're going to grab the bar and bring yourself over to the end of the song, wherever that is. And there we are. I can see the end of my song, and it doesn't quite fade out nicely. So again, I'm going to do my own manual fade out. I'm going to select the region, go up to the top to effects, and then fade out. So my first song is done, and I want to start talking again to introduce the interview I conducted today. So to do that, you have to be on your select tool and click on the track that you want to record to. So you can see I clicked back on this audio track here, not on the intro theme and not on the second song. And I think I'm going to come in right after the song finishes. So I'm just going to click there, and you'll see right where my cursor is, where the finger is pointing. Excuse me. Right where the finger's pointing, you'll see a nice little line, and that's where your recording starts for when you press the record button. So again, up at the top left, you click your record button, and I'm going to introduce the next part of the workshop. CKCU 93.1 FM radio show from home workshop, and then we're going to go into a Zoom interview. And then pressing space, or space bar, or the stop button to get rid of that, to stop recording, excuse me. And again, I blabbered on for no reason. So I can, while I'm on the select tool, select that region where I was just talking about how to stop the recording, highlight it, it'll be white, press delete, it goes away. Beautiful. All right, now you're asking me, how do I get this interview? Is it as like simple as the songs? It kind of is, kind of isn't. So we talked about Zoom being that setting where you can record all your members of your interview, including yourself, as different audio files, which is very helpful in a moment you'll see. So I'm going to go to my where I put those files, and Zoom will make a folder for you if you don't know where those are. And you can see here I have fake Zoom call Billy, fake Zoom call John, and fake Zoom call Mark. And what Zoom does, it makes, even if somebody's not talking for the entire duration of the interview, it will start their audio file at 00. In essence, it'll record nothing just so everything lines up perfectly. So you don't have to worry about manually lining it up. So what you can do to save yourself a bit of time is you select one of your files, hold Command or Control if you're on Windows, and then click each one. So I have my Billy audio line, my John audio line, and my Mark. So they're all three selected, and I can just drag that in. And normally there'd be some rendering involved, but right now it just threw those three, the two interviewers and the interviewee, it just threw them all there. And obviously that's not going to do us any good if our theme music is overlapping with the interview. So, similar to how we moved around the first song, we're going to select all of the interview audio, which we can do with the selection tool and dragging from the bottom left corner, bottom right corner, excuse me, all the way to the top left, or alternatively, like vice versa. So you can drag all the way down to select everything. Or there's one more way to do it, so it does it perfectly. You hold shift and just double click to the point. Oops, my apologies. So then it selects kind of just everything, but I would recommend just holding your mouse one button down and just dragging it all the way up. Oh, my apologies. All the way up. So now everything's selected. So I'm ready to move it. I can go to my move tool, my time stretch tool at the top, and just drag that all the way over after my first song. And as you can see, a lot of these files here, since they're all stereo files, are kind of taking up a lot of my screen real estate. And I can't really line it up that well with the end of my, like, kind of my outro to my song. So there's a little trick here we can do with Audacity to save, like, the real estate on your screen. And with any tool, it doesn't matter. The edges of the audio file or the tracks, can you'll see that icon there with the up and down arrows. You hold mouse one and drag up and down, which makes the waveform bigger or smaller. And generally, you can keep it small since you're not doing super fine tuning stuff, but some people like to have it big so they can edit the little parts out and such. But I'm for the purpose of this exercise, I'm gonna make them small so I can see what I'm doing. So all I'm doing is clicking at the edge of the track window and just dragging it down or dragging it up, depending on which way you're coming from. So there you go. I made Billy's small, made John's small, and now I'm doing the last person's audio file small. So now I can actually see what I'm doing. Great. But it's still not in the right spot, so we're going to select it all again. And then we're going to go back up to our move tool and just drag that to a nice spot. And I can't quite see, so I'm going to zoom in again by using the magnifying glass tool. Go back to my move tool and then drag it to the appropriate spot. So now I'll play it. You'll hear the rhythm of the, how much like the rhythm of everything has improved. CKCU 93.1 FM radio show from home workshop, and then we're going to go into a Zoom interview.
Hello, everyone. This is Billy.
So while not the best voice for it, it works. The rhythm is there, and we're super happy. We have our interview in. But there's some problems with the interview that we really need to fix if we want to make this ready for radio. So first of all, similar to the other files, we're going to need to fade in and fade out all of these audio files since it kind of pops in abruptly. So to do that, we can save a bit of time since they're all this more or less the same length of the file. We can select all three. And you can see here how my the three interviews are all selected, and I can do a fade out on all three at the same time. And while it's not very noticeable since the sound is so low, it worked. And we're going to do the same thing on the out, just to get ahead. Going to select all three. And with that, go up to effect and fade out. All right. So I'm going to play the interview, and I'm going to point out how one of the people that I interviewed, if you will, is a bit quieter, and we'll turn him up in a second. Mm-hmm.
Hello, everyone. This is Billy from the Example Show. I'm just interviewing John and Mark for their opinions on burgers and their favorite types of burgers. John, how you feeling?
Oh, I'm feeling great about burgers. How about you, Mark? How you doing?
Oh, you know, can't complain.
So, fellas, what's your favorite? So that's enough of that burger interview. We don't need that. And actually, I found out that I believe it's John, if I have the name right here. Yeah, John's a bit loud for me. You know, he's got a loud voice. So as mentioned way before, as a reminder, we're going to go over to the left of John's channel, and we're going to see that slider with the plus and minus. We're going to bring that down just a notch, maybe 3 dB. Because it's a nice even level, and it's going to even out. Because John has a loud voice, and he always wants to get his opinion about burgers in. But I found that Billy here, he's all right with the volume. So that's just an example to show you the kind of little the volume sliders, to like kind of like a mixer, if you will. So right now we leveled out the interview. It has its fade in and fade out. And we're going to go into one more song just for the sake of learning here, just to get it in. So right after my interview, I'm just going to go right into a song. So I'm going to open up my Finder, wherever it went. Just going to open up my documents here. Bear with me. Gonna put our last song in. We'll do the same thing, just drag it in. It's gonna render itself out, and then it's gonna plop itself in the most inconvenient spot ever. So once again, we're gonna double click it, go up to our move tool, and drag it over. And since we can't see from this, like kind of how zoomed out we are, I'm gonna go zoom in using the magnifying glass tool again. I'm going to go back to my move tool, since it's still selected, and drag that back over. And I'm going to want to fade that in as well, of course. So I'm going to go select from the beginning, select a long area here, go up to the top at effects, and fade it in. And just like that, it's jamming. And we'll listen to the end of that, just for the sake of hearing the difference. What do you think?
Well, I'm actually vegan, so you know, it's I still love my like tofu burgers and all that.
Well, thanks for your inputs, guys. It's been great. Cheers. So our burger show is looking really good. We're almost there, everyone. I'm sorry about the burger reference. It's just the only thing I could think of the other day, and it's not. I know it's not funny. It's just funny to me. It's sad. But it's okay. It's all for teaching. So we're at the end of almost. We're almost done, everyone. We're almost done. So my song, it has a fade out, but it's not quite perfect. So again. For the sixth time we've done it, I'm going to go up to effect, select the area, go up to effect, and fade it out. So right towards the end, I want to have kind of an outro, if you will. So I kind of don't know which track it is, and this is where my next point is. I'm kind of lost here looking at everything. So I'm going to have one little, kind of interject with one little tip, kind of get sidetracked. So at the left here, you can see that this one says audio track, this one says Adiodat, War, this one says fake Zoom call. These are all the names of the tracks. And to change those, all you have to do is click on the track and click name. And right there, you can set it to whatever you like. So we'll make it host so I know which one to look at again.
And then the rest we can more or less keep. I mean, with this one, we can just change it to Billy so we can see it easily without having to open it. And so on and so forth. When you're making projects, and in my experience working in a studio, and you have songs that have dozens and dozens of tracks, keeping things organized like this is essential to like not making yourself go crazy, because I know how infuriating technology can be and it can drive me bananas. So when you're setting your names and stuff, it's just good to stay organized, like just in life, you know? Not that I'm an organized guy, but it's a different conversation. So we're at the end of our song. You shouldn't be able to hear it, but I'll just visually looking, I can see it gets pretty silent around here. So I'm gonna just start recording right about here. I'm going to do an outro for the show. CKCU 91.1 I fudged it up. Let's try that again. Okay, to try it again, this is a good example. I almost forgot. So, I mean, you don't have to select and delete it. You can just press Command-Z. Or you can Control-Z if you're on Windows. Or you can go up to your edit and go Undo Record, which is the last thing I did. I already did it, but you would see Undo Record, or you can delete it, however you prefer. And we'll try that one more time. Hopefully the last time. CKCU 93.1 FN, you've been listening to the Burger Podcast and the Workshop Example Show. Have a good night, everyone. You've been great. And then I press stop. And we're going to fix that up real quick. I'm just going to make sure everything's tip-top. Zooming in with the magnifying tool. Fading out my ending section. And we are jamming. So there's my show, right? And you can always go in and adjust your levels more. I mean, the biggest thing is just use your ears. Like the songs themselves generally don't have to move. You don't have to move their sliders up and down, because most songs are professionally mastered. But if you do have to a little bit, if a song, say like a song from the 50s or 60s, they can be mastered pretty quietly and exported pretty quietly. So you can add 1 or 2 dB, but don't go crazy. But voices, as long as you got your good level here, but from the monitoring, when we were aiming for that negative 18, negative 12 range, You can always turn them up, and if people are too loud, you just turn them down, since we have full control at this point to change everything. So right now, I'm pretty happy with my show. I have a really low bar for it, and the burger kind of fandom is not very keen on like a polished product. So it's all good, though. We're almost there. So you might think you're done, you can just hit the export button, but you're wrong. I didn't need to do that. Anyways, we're almost done. But there's one more thing we need to do. We need to combine all this stuff into one file that we'll eventually send to Dylan. Or whoever. Whoever's hanging out at the station. And to do that, it's quite simple. We have all of our files here. All the levels are good. What we're going to do is we're going to go to the top, press select, and then go to all. And what that's going to do, it's going to select from the very beginning to the very end. And it's great. So everything is selected. You won't miss out on a single audio file, because it will always go to the end. After that, we're going to render it down to one file to work with. So to do that, we're going to go up to tracks, right where effect was and stuff. We're going to go to the mix sidebar, and then we're going to go mix and render to new track. And what that's doing right now is it's taking every single one of these elements here, indicated with my cursor. This, like the my theme song, me talking, the song, the interview, and the last song. It's going to put it all into one big file here, as you can see. But as you can see, it's kind of all over the place in terms of volume. And we're going to fix that. We're going to kind of normalize it, if you will, or limit it. So to do that, first, we need to mute all of our other tracks, because we don't want to hear two copies of everything, because it's going to blow your ears off. So to do that, under where you see the name, you'll see a mute and you'll see a solo. And what mute does, it mutes it. It shuts off the audio. You won't hear the audio, and it turns it gray. Kind of like that. So you can see that it went from blue, which means I'm going to be able to hear it, to gray. And alternatively, there's the solo button. So solo does the opposite. It makes everything else gray, but just that is soloed. So however you want to do it, it's up to you. But what's easier is just pressing solo. So right now, everything is muted. Everything's highlighted gray. It automatically mutes it for you when you press solo. And what we need to do, so you can see how the waveform here is kind of all over the place. We need to select all of it. We need to go up to effect. We go all the way down past a lot of these effects and go to limiter. And what that does, it cuts off so it doesn't clip, but then it brings everything else up. So it makes it to a listenable level. So with that, we're going to go type, because there's some good presets in here, and go to hard limit. So it's going to bring it up. It's not as hard as you think. It's still pretty soft, but it's a good preset for everyone to use. So right now, we're going to leave the first two settings at 0 dB, and we're going to go to limit to -1 dB. So it could be different for certain people, depending on your version. It could be -3, it could be -5, but we're going to bring it up to -1. The hold we can keep at 10 milliseconds. And for apply makeup gain, we're going to go yes, because we want to make the quieter things louder and the louder things a bit quieter. We're going to even it out. And we're going to click OK, and it's going to do its thing. And you can see there that this got louder. Due to my human error, I realized how loud this past song was. So we're going to just ignore that for now. But imagine that this song, the first song I played, was as quiet as that one. It's going to bump everything up evenly. Because I kind of picked a bad song for an example. But in the example file I will give you at the end, I will give you better songs. Yes.
You're going to have to go back 15 seconds.
Oh, I cut out?
Yeah.
Classic. So, where did I end?
Just go back. You were talking about your human error and that being loud.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
so, we limited everything, brought everything up louder, but not to a point where it's clipping. But due to my negligence, I put in this song here. My first song was a bit loud, and I kind of forgot to bring it down here. So what I can do to fix that is I'm going to just delete this whole thing. It seems like we're going backwards, but I just want to make sure everyone does it right. We're going to delete this whole thing by pressing the X button beside it. And that's going to get rid of that, that render. And we're going to unmute things here so we can hear what we're doing. And I'm going to go back and just fix. I'm just going to turn down that first song because it's just way too loud. We'll maybe turn it down 5 dB. So again, to render the whole thing, once you have all your tracks, you're going to select all from the top. Going to go up to tracks, go to mix, and then mix and render to new track. And that's going to, again, render the whole thing as one file. And just like that, it's way more even. The song I chose for this example is not great because it's a very compressed song, but you can blatantly see, as from before, these blue lines were touching the top, and now they're about even with the second song. So now we can properly do our limiting. So again, once we render everything out, we're going to press solo. So we don't want to hear anything else. We're going to double click our new rendered file labeled mix. And we're going to go to effect all the way down to limiter and go to hard limit. That's going to render itself out. And then it's going to bring itself up to a more reasonable level that's good for the radio. And I'll be linking everyone. I don't know the timing. It might be probably tomorrow night. I'm going to have a file that's going to be put together similar to this, extremely similar. So you can see what I did and you can see how everything's laid out, because it's impossible to just remember everything I've said since it's a wash of information. So you'll have access to this project file towards tomorrow night, I believe. Anyways, we're almost there. So we have our final product that's limited properly. And the last thing we're going to do is we're going to go select it all. We're going to go file, export, export as MP3. We're going to name it. I'm going to save it to my desktop, name it CKCU example workshop example. We're going to go, we're going to see bitrate mode where it has preset, variable, average, and constant. We're going to click constant. We have a quality drop down menu. We're going to have it at the highest, which is 320 kilobits per second. And for the channel mode, we're going to put it in stereo. So for everyone, their presets are going to be different. So you might, I'm just telling you this, even though mine were already there, yours may not be. So again, bitrate mode is constant. Quality is 320 kilobits per second. And your channel mode is stereo. And with that, we can save it. We can delete all this stuff. Metadata tags are kind of like how iTunes reads stuff, but we don't need any of that for this. So we're going to click clear. We're going to clear all that information because we do not need that. And then we're going to go to OK, and it's going to export itself out. So we're basically almost there, right? Right now, we're only going to go upload this, and we're going to upload it and then make our playlist for people who are not familiar. But we finished our file, but we never gave it to Dave or Dylan. So we need to do that because then all of our hard work won't be, it won't matter. So you log on to your COD, and you'll go to your playlist. And you'll see your program. I can see I'm part of Homemade Mixtape, so I'll go to there. You'll go to upload your playlist. No, not upload there. You start a new playlist. My apologies. You go to type in a new playlist, and I'm sure all of you know how to do that. You've done it before. So you'll have your host, your title theme, your text, your artist album track. And then you'll, let's just fill in a bunch of gibberish just so we can refer to it. We have our playlist, and we're going to actually need to give them the audio file for that. So to do that, it'll bring us, we'll see, we'll go to the playlist again, and you'll see, how do you get that? View show info page, and you'll see my new show called ASD ASD, which is not the greatest name, but to upload that show for whatever we made, we click on that, and beside it, you'll see an upload bar beside about, beside prior playlist. We'll click that, and we'll just simply click upload audio file, and we'll upload our workshop example.mp3. And I'm not going to upload this one because it's just, I'll upload the better version that I have, but that's how you do it. You just click that and click open, and then it would upload for you.
Okay, so you ready, Matt?
I'm super ready.
Can you play from the host computer to record, or Sunny with Spotify?
Doing that requires a bit, depending on your system. It sounds like it should be easy, but it's really not. Basically, it requires external software and such.
Are you referring to like what you do in the studio?
Kinda, yeah.
You can't do that. That's what Matt's explaining.
Cannot?
You can't, you basically, so to do that, the station already has a whole bunch of software and has that mixer board pre-installed to function like that, but home computers do not have that capability.
Do we have ads to PlayStation, IDs, and such? That is stuff that Dylan and Dave can provide to you if you email them for your show, your intro music, things like that. If you email them, they'll be able to send you what you need. Then we have another question, and that is, where do we see the time of the show when we are recording?
So I should have brought that up actually. So we have our screen here, but at right below our toolbar, there's a time scale. So it's a bit small to see on through Zoom.
Okay,
but I see it now. If you have it, you can see it goes up to 2, 3, 4, and it depends how much you're zoomed in. And if you zoom in more, it will adjust its scale accordingly. So if I were to zoom in right now, I can see that my show is exactly 11 minutes and like 26 seconds. So it's hard to see on the Zoom, which is not the greatest, but okay. If you see below your toolbar, you'll see like a time scale. So you can see how long your show actually is.
I have another question. I want to do it like from my CD player directly. Can I do that with a mixer if I get a DJ mixer?
Yeah. So kind of, I wonder if I should just bring it up now or later, but actually I can do it really quick. So you can see, do you see where my mouse is right now?
Yes.
And it says Steinberg UR22 Mark II.
Yeah.
So that's my interface or my mic source. So okay. I can plug anything into that. So for your example, you have a DJ mixer. If you were to go in through your interface or even in directly through the DJ mixer, you can click on it and you would see your DJ mixer here.
Okay.
And just like how my voice was recorded, it'll record your DJ mixer as such.
Okay, great.
Yeah. So if you want to do it like that, you can do it like that. And then just always make sure you'll see your levels as like when it's music, it's usually between -6 and 0 and voices between -18 and -12. So when you're seeing songs and you're seeing it red line at the top there, that's yeah. Okay, because those songs have been mastered by a professional. So they won't actually go above 0, but they'll just touch it.
Okay.
So.
Okay. That's great to know.
Yeah. While you're working on all this stuff, save. So at the top, like save as you go so you don't lose your work, because that would just suck after working on something for half an hour. So to save your file in the first place, you go file, save project as, and then whatever the name of your project is. Right now it's called CKCU example work in progress. So I've already done that. But always go up to the top when you're working on something, go to save project and just go save project, not save project as. So that way, if your computer shuts down, if you lose power, if something crashes, you're going to be able to just start right back from where you left off. So I should mention, you should try to do that every 5 minutes. Get into a habit of it, because it can save your life and your sanity.